Welcome students. In this video, let us look at the x-intercept and y-intercept of a circle. X-intercept and y-intercept. So what is x-intercept and y-intercept of a circle? So let us take this circle and let us say that the circle cuts x-axis at 2 points AB and y-axis at 2 points CD. So the distance between A and B, this distance is called the x-intercept and the distance CD is called the y-intercept. So the distance between the two points where the circle cuts x-axis is called the x-intercept of the circle, and the distance between C and D, this is called the y-intercept of this circle. If the circle touches x-axis, this A and B just coincides. If these two points become closer and closer and closer, and if they merge, that means the circle is touching x-axis. So if the circle touches x-axis, the x-intercept is equal to 0. And if the circle touches y-axis, then the y-intercept will be equal to 0. And if the circle is not touching x-axis, the circle might lie completely above x-axis. The circle might lie here. For the circle, x-intercept is not defined, neither y-intercept is defined. So intercepts are defined if the circle touches or cuts x-axis and the circle touches or cuts y-axis. Now, how do I find the value of the x-intercept and how do I find the value of y-intercept if the equation of circle is given? So let the circle be x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Now, if you want the x-intercept, I'll find the abscess of the first point and the abscess of the second point. If I subtract one from the other, if I subtract x1 from x2, I get the value of AB. Similarly, if I find these points y1 and y2 and find the difference between y2 and y1, you get the value of the y-intercept. So first, let us try to find these two x-intercepts. So obviously, how do I find these two points? These are the two points where the y-coordinate of the point is equal to 0. So to find the axis of A and B, I put y is equal to 0 in my equation, because for the points on x-axis, y coordinate is equal to 0. These points will be of the form x comma 0. So if you put y is equal to 0, implies x square plus 2gx plus c is equal to 0. This is a quadratic. This has two roots, x1 and x2. One will be the abscess of the first point, the other will be the abscess of the second point, right? Now, once you have x1 and x2, how do I find the magnitude of difference between the roots? We have already studied this in the topic of quadratic equations. So, mod of x2 minus x1 is equal to root of x1 plus x2 whole square minus 4 x1 x2. And what is the sum of the roots? Sum of the roots is minus 2g for this equation. Product of the roots is c. So that is equal to root of x1 plus x2 whole square, that is 4g square minus 4 times x1 x2 is c. So this 4 can be taken out. So that is equal to 2 root g square minus c. So 2 root g square minus c is the formula for x-intercept. Similarly, if you want the y-intercept, this is for x-intercept. So for y-intercept, you need these two points. So these points are of the form 0 comma y. So you put x is equal to 0. So y square plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. This equation has two roots y1 and y2. So the difference between the roots is needed. Follow the same process. You get y-intercept is equal to 2 root f square minus c. So 2 root g square minus c is the x-intercept. 2 root f square minus c is the y-intercept. As simple as that. So the x-intercept of the circle is given by 2 root g square minus c, and the y-intercept is given by 2 root f square minus c. Now what are the different cases possible? When will a circle touch x-axis? If a circle touches x-axis, that means these two points coincide with each other and the distance between A and B will become 0, right? So if the circle touches x-axis, then x-intercept has to be equal to 0. So g square has to be equal to c, or c is equal to g square. And if the circle cuts x-axis at two points, then g square has to be greater than c. If g square is greater than c, you get some positive value inside the square root. So you get some finite x-intercept. If the circle does not cut x-axis, if the circle is somewhere where it does not cut x-axis, obviously x-intercept should not be defined. So you get g square minus c as a negative number. So root of negative number will not be defined. So if g square minus c is less than 0, you should understand that the circle is not cutting x-axis. Similar results can be thought of with respect to y-intercept. If f square is equal to c, then the circle touches y-axis. If f square is greater than c, cuts y-axis. F square less than c, it does not cut y-axis. Next, if the circle touches both the axes, then both x-intercept and y-intercept has to be equal to 0. So g square and f square both have to be equal to c. So g square has to be equal to f square, has to be equal to c. Now, do you see that these conditions are very similar to the conditions we got in the topic of special equations? So in the special equations also, if the circle touches x-axis, we have found that the constant has to be the square of half of x coefficient, that is g. And if the circle touches y-axis, the constant has to be the square of the coefficient of y by 2, that is f square. So all these concepts get connected if you observe all the topics carefully. Thank you.